Hey guys, welcome back to another exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess, and in today's tutorial we are back with our new logo design. And this logo looks like a long strip of paper is being folded for a multiple number of times to form a unique shape. So to design this logo, we'll follow four steps. First, we'll use the basic shapes, that's a rectangle. Then we'll use the line segment to create the divisions, and then we'll use the shape editor to bring out the exact shape which is required. And then finally we'll use the gradient color to fill up the colors from the gradient palette, and then the text. So let's begin the tutorial. First, so let's select the rectangle tool and left click your mouse button. So here we got the width and height. In width we'll put 170 points and height around 220 points. So and click OK. So you got a rectangle of certain width and height. Now duplicate this, Control C, Control F, and paste it under and scale it down. And to scale it down, we'll use the transform option here. And here we'll lock this and then keep the width around 110 and click OK. So you got it. And change the color to white. So you can see we have duplicated and scaled it down to 110 width, and the height will be adjusted proportionally. So after that, we'll use the line segment tool and draw the straight line from here, and make sure the points should be starting from the intersection. Just click, drag it down until intersection here, and fill it with some dark color like black stroke color. Then from here again, from this intersection to this intersection here. So for all these sides we'll do that, from here till intersection, again from here till here. So once you have made all these layer, we'll do next step. From this point till this point, draw out a line. From this point till this point, draw the line. In the same way, from this point, draw out a line. From this point, draw out a line. So with the line segment tool, we are basically dividing the shapes which we need for to create this logo. Now, after we're doing that, we'll do one thing here. We'll just zoom in and duplicate this line segment. Before they just select both of this, the small rectangle and the bigger rectangle, and go to Pathfinder and just subtract it. So we are left only this portion, so that's all. We don't need that smaller one, so we have subtracted that. Now we are doing is we'll select this piece, duplicate this, Control C and Control F to paste in different, and with the keyboard arrow key just move aside like 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. I have given 10 spaces between them. In the same way, I'll select this, Control C, Control F, and again with the arrow keys just move aside 1 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So this has been given. Again, just select this piece, Control C, Control F, and move 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So once you have given that, I think this is just like this, fine. So you can see we have done that. Now little bit more here, select again the line segments, and we will do this. So we'll be intersecting from, not from here, from this point till this. In the same way, from here till here, and this one from here till here, and from here till here. So we'll just making the shapes closed, and after that one line from intersection till this intersection. So make sure everything is done. And once you are given all the lines, I mean their proper places, now select everything, and with a shape builder tool we'll just create all the shapes which we require. So we need this plate, so we'll just select all of these and make sure it's filled with color like that, so that we can see what is going on like that. And this piece should be combined, this is a separate piece, this one till this one is one piece, this one another piece. You can see this upper piece is one plate, so we'll just make sure it's one plate like that and just combine it. Now this piece, so once you have done all of that, we can see that we have gained all the basic shape which we require. Now we'll select all the pieces, 1 2 3 4 5 6, and move it a little bit aside like that, and delete all the rest of the part which you don't need that. Now the next step is to fill it with some gradient color. So to fill the gradient color, we'll do these steps. First, select this with the eye picker, just select the colors. So this one with this, this one with this. Maybe we can select all of them together like this, this, and this. And with the eye picker, shift alt pressed, select the colors. This one and this one. We need some lighter color like this. And this one already filled. Now we'll use the gradient tool to do the adjustment like that. From here till here, select this gradient tool. From here till here, maybe on the opposite side like that. Select this and G from here till here. So we need dark on the top and lighter on the bottom. In the same way, select this from here till here. Here is light and here is dark. This one, G, like that, dark to light. So we can just push it up a little bit and just lower it down in the same way. Last piece, we are left with that, gradient tool, light, dark to light, like that. So once you have achieved all the colors you needed, now the next thing is the text. So let's use the text. We are writing euro. We are given the name and the font which we are using is Circle Mazzola. That's that. We'll select and just write as a KL Circle Mazzola and click OK, and we'll increase the font size, make sure it's fit the length of the logo. So scale it up a little bit, yep, like that. We're using regular and the color we'll choose from here. Let's select with the eye picker like that. So place the text in the perfect position like that. Should be aligned and the size should be perfect. You can see it's right now. So we have completed our logo, we have put it the gradient colors, and finally we have used the text. So this is how we can create these kinds of logo. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.